Diabetes is a common chronic condition that affects millions of people worldwide. It is characterized by impaired insulin function, a hormone responsible for regulating blood sugar levels. When insulin fails to work properly, glucose or sugar accumulates in the blood instead of being used as a source of energy for the body's cells. Over time, this high blood sugar can cause various complications, one of which is chronic pain. The relationship between diabetes and chronic pain lies in the damage it causes to the peripheral nerves, leading to a condition known as neuropathic pain. But what exactly is neuropathic pain? To understand this, we need to delve into the concept of peripheral neuropathy. So, let's talk about painful diabetic neuropathy today. Peripheral neuropathy refers to the damage or dysfunction of nerves that lie outside the brain and spinal cord. These nerves, called peripheral nerves, play a crucial role in transmitting signals between the brain and different parts of the body. When these nerves are damaged due to the prolonged high blood sugar levels in diabetes, they can misfire and send pain signals to the brain even when there is no injury or external trigger. This abnormal pain perception is what we refer to as neuropathic pain. One specific form of neuropathic pain, often associated with diabetes, is called painful diabetic neuropathy. As the name suggests, this condition is characterized by chronic pain that usually affects the feet and legs, but it can also affect the hands and arms. The pain can range from mild discomfort to severe debilitating sensations, making it challenging for individuals to perform daily activities. In addition to chronic pain, diabetic neuropathy can present with a range of other symptoms that affect the nerves throughout the body. Some of the symptoms include numbness or reduced ability to feel pain or temperature changes, especially in the feet and toes. And damage to the sensory nerves can lead to a loss of sensation, making it difficult for individuals to detect injuries or changing temperature in their feet and toes. This lack of sensation can put them at risk of developing serious foot problems without even realizing it. Watch my other video about diabetic foot. Tingling and burning feelings. Many individuals with diabetic neuropathy may experience a constant tingling sensation or a burning feeling in the affected areas. This discomfort can be bothersome and disrupt daily activities. A sharp, jabbing pain that may be worse at night. The pain associated with diabetic neuropathy can vary in intensity and may be more severe during the nighttime, making it challenging for individuals to get adequate rest. Extreme sensitivity to touch. Some people may develop hypersensitivity to touch, where even the slightest pressure or touch can cause intense pain. This heightened sensitivity can lead to avoidance of contact and further impact their quality of life. Muscle weakness. Damage to motor nerves can result in muscle weaknesses, making it difficult to perform certain movements or maintain balance and coordination. Loss of reflex response. Reflexes are involuntary responses controlled by the nervous system. Diabetic neuropathy can impair these reflexes, affecting the normal functioning of the body. Serious foot problems. Peripheral neuropathy in the feet can lead to serious complications such as foot ulcers, infections, deformities, and bone and joint damage. Without proper sensation, individuals may not notice injuries or infections in their feet, which can escalate into severe problems if left untreated. It is important to be aware of the symptoms and seek medical attention if you experience any of them. Early diagnosis and appropriate management can help prevent further complications and improve the overall outcome for individuals with diabetic neuropathy. Regular checkups with healthcare professionals, especially for those with diabetes, can play a significant role in identifying and managing neuropathic symptoms effectively. Please remember that this video is for educational purposes only. If you have a condition that could be causing your symptoms, talk to your doctor. In case of emergency, please go to the nearest emergency department or call an ambulance. Treating painful diabetic neuropathy can be a difficult task, and often prevention is the key to avoid this condition. Maintaining a good control of blood sugar levels is vital in reducing the risk of developing neuropathic pain. This involves adhering to a healthy diet, regular exercises, and taking medications as prescribed by a healthcare professional to keep blood sugar levels within the target range. If painful diabetic neuropathy does occur, there are treatment options available. Medications belonging to the anticonvulsant group, such as gabapentin and pregabalin, have shown promise in managing neuropathic pain. Watch my other videos about gabapentin and pregabalin. These drugs work by stabilizing overactive nerves and reducing the abnormal pain signals being sent to the brain. Additionally, antidepressants like amitriptyline and duloxetine have also been used to treat painful diabetic neuropathy. These medications can help by altering the brain's perception of pain and improving mood, which is especially crucial as chronic pain can lead to emotional distress and depression. Watch my other videos about amitriptyline here and duloxetine here. If you like this video so far, give a thumbs up here and subscribe to this channel. Exercises offer a multitude of benefits for individuals with diabetes. It is a powerful tool that can help manage blood sugar levels and improve overall health. Here are some of the significant benefits of exercises for diabetes. 1. Better blood sugar control. Physical activity helps lower blood sugar levels by increasing the uptake of glucose by muscles, reducing insulin resistance, and enhancing insulin sensitivity. These effects persist even after exercise, leading to improved long-term blood sugar control. 2. Weight management. Regular exercise can aid in weight loss or weight maintenance, which is essential for individuals with type 2 diabetes. Achieving and maintaining a healthy weight can improve insulin sensitivity and reduce the risk of complications associated with obesity. 3. Cardiovascular health. Exercise is excellent for heart health. It can reduce the risk of cardiovascular diseases such as heart attack, a stroke, which are more common in people with diabetes. 4. Improve cholesterol levels. Physical activity can increase high-density lipoprotein, HDL cholesterol, the good cholesterol, and reduce low-density lipoprotein, LDL cholesterol, the bad cholesterol, leading to an improved lipid profile. 5. Lower blood pressure. Regular exercises help lower blood pressure, reducing the risk of hypertension, another common complication of diabetes. 6. Increase energy levels. Engaging in regular physical activity can boost energy levels and reduce fatigue, contributing to an improved quality of life. 7. Stress reduction. Exercise is a natural stress reliever. Managing stress is important for people with diabetes, as stress hormones can affect blood sugar levels. 8. Better sleep. Regular exercise can promote better sleep quality, which is essential for overall well-being and diabetes management. Number 9, enhanced muscle strength and flexibility. Physical activity can improve muscle strength and flexibility, making daily activities and movements easier to perform. Number 10, improved insulin utilization during exercise. Exercise can lead to a better balance between insulin and glucose levels during physical activity, reducing the risk of hypoglycemia, low blood sugar, for people on insulin therapy. And number 11, lower risk of complications. By improving overall health and blood sugar control, regular exercise can help reduce the risk of diabetes-related complications such as neuropathy, retinopathy, and kidney disease. It is essential to consult with a healthcare professional before starting an exercise routine, especially if you have pre-existing health conditions. The healthcare provider can provide guidance on the most suitable exercise regimen based on individual health status and the diabetes management goals. A combination of aerobic exercise such as walking, cycling, or swimming, along with resistance training, can be beneficial for managing diabetes effectively. And remember to monitor blood sugar levels during and after exercise, and be cautious about any signs of hypoglycemia or hyperglycemia. With a well-designed exercise plan, individuals with diabetes can experience significant improvements in their health and well-being. Please leave your comment in the section below. Answer this question: do you have diabetes, or do you know someone who has diabetes? And I hope to see you in my next video. Thank you for watching today. Goodbye.